Mother and son had big smiles riding to church Sunday morning near her Balmoral estate in Scotland. The death of Jeffrey Epstein has turned into an epic political scandal hitting the halls of power on both sides of the Atlantic. That includes the palaces of the British royal family because of Prince Andrew's decades-long friendship with Epstein and his alleged sexual encounters with one of the financier's underage sex slaves in the early 2000s. Nonetheless, the royal family has showed its support for Andrew in recent months even as Epstein's alleged sex trafficking operation came under intensified scrutiny by the media and federal investigators, leading to his arrest July 6. On Andrew's behalf, Buckingham Palace has repeatedly denied the sex abuse allegations against him, while the Duke of York has continued to represent the royal family at official events, including during President Donald Trump's state visit to the UK in June. The royal family's continued support was apparent this weekend even after 2,000 pages of unsealed court documents revealed new details about Andrew's travels with Epstein and his alleged groping of a young woman at a party at Epstein's Manhattan mansion. A day after Epstein was found dead in his Manhattan jail cell, the Queen was photographed with her second son, riding to church near her Balmoral estate in Scotland where he's vacationing or hiding out, depending on your point of view, with ex-wife Sarah Ferguson and their two daughters. The 92-year-old monarch and her 59-year-old son, often said to be her favorite, had big smiles as they rode in the back of a car. The British media took the opportunity to photograph the royal family showing solidarity for the embattled Duke of York. The Duke's oldest daughter, Princess Beatrice, also rode with them, according to the New York Post. But reports suggest that Andrew's problems with the Epstein scandal are far from over. In fact, the registered sex offender's death could bring a whole new raft of problems for Andrew, according to reports. The FBI is investigating the circumstances that led to the death of such a high-profile prisoner, who possibly possessed potentially embarrassing information about Andrew and a number of other powerful men, including President Donald Trump and former President Bill Clinton. Meanwhile, the Miami Herald reported that the investigation that led to Epstein's arrest also is shifting to his associates, notably British socialite Ghislaine Maxwell, who is accused of procuring girls for Epstein to have sex with and having sex with some of the girls herself. In a statement, prosecutors in the Southern District of New York confirmed that their criminal case involving Epstein's alleged sex trafficking operation continues. That's potentially bad news for Andrew because Maxwell was said to be a close friend and a regular guest at his apartment in Buckingham Palace, the Daily Beast reported over the weekend, citing its report in July about Maxwell allegedly seeking to provide women for Andrew to have sex with in London. A guest at one of Epstein's parties at his palatial Manhattan townhouse also told the Daily Beast that everyone in New York had heard the rumors that Ghislaine's job was to provide a stream of pretty women for Epstein. The guest attended a party where Andrew was the guest of honor. Epstein was clearly confident in Andrew's presence, and was trading off him, basking in the reflected glory of having a prince at his table, the guest told the Daily Beast. He wanted to show how comfortable he was in his presence, and make clear that while he was a guest of honor, he was a regular, routine, and repeat guest. Epstein, Andrew, and Ghislaine were a trio, a little coterie, a party within the party, the insiders among the other guests, the guest added. The Daily Beast added that the ongoing investigation could include a look into any financial favors Andrew received from Epstein during their friendship, which reportedly began in the 1990s. Sarah Ferguson admitted that she was a recipient of one of those favors. Ferguson told the Daily Telegraph in a 2011 interview that Andrew, with whom she has maintained friendly relations since their 1996 divorce, had helped arrange for Epstein to pay more than $18,000 to one of her former assistants to whom she owed nearly $100,000 in unpaid wages and other bills. Ferguson admitted in the interview that her taking the money from the registered sex offender was a gigantic error of judgment.